Want to buy some secret stuff? Want to engage in a transaction with some other consenting adult that you don't want the government to know about? That is easier now, thanks to Freedom 2.0, which brought us something called Bitcoin.
Brother, can you spare a Bitcoin?
Bitcoin. You never heard of them a few weeks ago? Now everybody's talking about them, but is it a currency?
I don't know. Or is it more like a stock? Or is it a tulip bulb?
Or is
We're
it just
debate that.
Stupid.
Have you ever heard of Bitcoin? It's a digital currency that's gaining popularity. It exists only online. Tell you the truth, I honestly don't get it. Why not use regular dollars? Well, the man who is behind Bitcoin, that business, he's here, and he'll join us next.
To me, it smells like Ponzi scheme and the greater fool theory right now.
An ancillary trend that I see moving forward in 2012 is the emergence of Bitcoins.
Bitcoins, maybe I should get some. Do you have any?
Well, I'll tell you what, I don't know what to do exactly with Bitcoin, and they don't look a bit like these coins. Matter of fact, they're kind of in the Ethernet. What are they?
We have something called the Bitcoin. Now, what's the Bitcoin?
Bitcoin top 100 rich list. From 3rd of June, 2011.
This is fantastic. This is the new Forbes fortune list, isn't it? These are the Bitcoin fortunes. It's pure anonymous, and this is the biggest story of this decade going forward, is the transition from the old way of doing business around the world to the Bitcoin way of doing business, which is purely anonymous. And this is the great achievement of the global insurrection against banker occupation. Bitcoin is the currency of the resistance.
Paying for something without hard cash, credit cards, or checks. It's a new form of virtual payment known as Bitcoins. CNN's Felicia Taylor looks at how it works.
I think while most people think of digital currency as only having value in a video game like Farmville, this digital currency can actually be transferred as payment to anyone in the world. It can be exchanged for real currency like dollars or euros, and it actually can be used as payment to buy anything from books to food to illegal drugs in some markets.
Samir Taqi, co-founder of BitcoinConsultancy.com.
I must say that your show was one of the first to start reporting on Bitcoin, and you actually gave a very, very informative coverage of it compared to the later sensationalist news afterwards.
All right, we're going to talk about the cyber threat now. And who's ever heard of the Bitcoin, this underground person-to-person web exchange currency?
It's anonymous and untraceable, so criminals can trade drugs and guns online with Bitcoin.
And it's almost completely anonymous. Now, why is that good, you might say? People will use it to buy illegal guns and drugs. And they do, actually, already. But Catherine Mangu Ward of Reason Magazine says, on balance, that's a good thing. A good thing? Why?
So the first thing you have to keep in mind is that Bitcoins are no more kind of suspicious or anonymous than cash. Already, people use cash all the time to buy illegal, illicit stuff they don't want their wife to know about. There's a lot of room for transactions that we might not want a permanent record of. Right now, that's cash, but now we have Bitcoins, which are digital.
How many times have you suddenly started to hear people talk about these Bitcoins?
Now, if you didn't bite at the Bitcoin craze, you may have saved yourself some money. Mary Thompson is here. What was that with the flash crash?
Well, I don't know, Mandy. You know, 2 days ago, of course, the currency was turning heads at $240. Today, investors are turning tail. Bitcoin's value plummeting to a low at $54.25 each overnight, a stunning 77% decline, recovering to just over $73 now. Bitcoin's still making money for investors who got early, though. Its recent rise, fueled by demand from investors looking for a place to stash cash during the Cyprus crisis.
Maybe it's a little bit shady.
Well, you know,
if
I had a Bitcoin and I was paying you in Bitcoins, they could basically look at our account numbers, but it has nothing to do with our identity. So mm-hmm. You can buy things again with no one knowing.
Well, we don't
your
even
identity.
Know who invented this.
No,
right?
We
There's
don't.
Some rumors that it's this Japanese guy, but they're saying no, that he's a fake name. It was a pseudonym.
You're no
literally
idea.
Putting real money onto a system that we don't even know who created it.
No, mm-hmm. No, not at all. It's kind of an amazing story.
It really is.
You're a consultant, a Bitcoin consultant, and as you point out, there's been some quite a spread in how this story is being reported. And it invites quite a passionate response.
Why do you believe there are risks in using Bitcoins?
Well, when you think about money, first I have to give Bitcoin creators credit. At least they know enough not to trust fiat money that's controlled by our government. But they're trying to reinvent the wheel, and they've come up with a flat tire. We already have a perfect real form of money, and it's called gold. Money has to have four elements. It has to be very rare, indestructible, divisible without losing its purchasing power, and cannot be increased by fiat. And Bitcoins fail on the first two. They are not rare, and they are very much destructible.
Well, what's the value of one Bitcoin?
I mean, I think right now the one Bitcoin goes for about
$110,
and I think it's skyrocketing precisely because of all these great aspects about it.
The whole Bitcoin market is about $1 billion. It's a novelty for the geek squad. I can assure you, if these became well promulgated, then the U.S. government would shut it down.
And just to give our viewers some perspective, there's about $4 trillion in currency trading every day, and as Michael said, it's about $1 billion worth of Bitcoins.
Sure,
that's very good perspective. So, is this getting any traction in the markets then, Jeff?
Well, yeah, absolutely it is. I mean, it has quintupled in value over the last year. Just since the Cyprus thing came up, it's up over 20%. Over the last month, or a couple months, it's up over 40%. So it's actually getting some visibility out there. Again, you can go online and go to places where Bitcoins are accepted, and there are dozens of places. No websites that you would actually, if I said them, oh, yeah, I know that. But it's just going to be very interesting to see just how much this catches on. It just sounds so silly, but maybe it's not.
David, you want to get paid in Bitcoins?
No, I don't want to get paid in U.S. dollars, but in the same sense, I don't want to get paid in gold either.
David, how much of your wealth will you place in Bitcoins? What percentage
I believe that for any sort of a highly diversified portfolio, something like Bitcoin is going to play an increasing role.
But if it is widely promulgated, and the exponential increase of someone trying to hack it, because there'd be many more people trying to hack it, goes up.
Well, I guess you're assuming that merely that because you can theorize the possibility that's going to happen. I would say the reason that there is $1 billion of value in it is because it's been carefully analyzed.
Your purchasing power can be wiped out in a nanosecond, and that's why it would never be widely accepted in this country.
I hear you say that, but that doesn't make it true. And I think that there are people who spend a lot of time on this that might know this topic maybe a bit more and who would believe in it. And I guess I would say that there are...
What percentage of Americans? I know I have an IT department who, when they went through this, and they said, I would never trust this. So if my IT department isn't going to trust it, it's not going to be widely accepted.
We got to get some Bitcoins over to Cyprus, that's for
sure. Don't try to throw them in
my gold. Buy gold instead.
We'll see you soon, guys. We'll be watching that story.
There's a new currency that's growing in popularity. It's even being called the future of money. The Bitcoin isn't controlled by a government or a central bank. It's a completely virtual currency that's traded on the internet, but it can create very real wealth.
Standard PC, but it has a high-end graphics card.
Terry Floyd is known as a Bitcoin miner. The blue thing in there. He and tens of thousands like him around the world use their upgraded home computers to do the communal accounting, to double-check every transaction.
0, 4, 5, 6.
In return, he's rewarded with some brand new Bitcoin every now and again. His wallet's now worth thousands of dollars for helping to secure the system.
All right, now hang on. I want to go. It's a hot topic on Wall Street right now. It's very interesting. Digital money called Bitcoin. I can't resist doing this. Digital money called Bitcoin. But the value of this money is like totally unpredictable. It fluctuates from $20 a unit to $260 a unit and all the way back down. In fact, today, trading was halted. So how do you know to make Bitcoin real money? How can we make Bitcoin real money? I have a very simple solution, Larry, because I like this digital money. Link it to gold. Bitcoin, digital money, link it to gold. You've got an alternative currency to the dollar and all the Fed shenanigans, and I think that would be totally cool.
Well, that was the amazing dynamic was the weakness in gold this last 10 days and the birth explosion of Bitcoin. I heard an interesting story. One of my good friends had some Bitcoin a couple of years ago. He was going through a divorce, $2,000 or $3,000 worth. He put it on one of his PCs, okay? He had like 10 PCs. He's lost the Bitcoin. And on Monday, he calls me. It's worth $26,000. He lost. In other words, the Bitcoin was actually the file was on a PC, and he couldn't find it.
Oh, I see.
By the time he called me today, he was almost in tears because the Bitcoin value was down 50, 60%.
But if they linked it, it, if they linked it, I mean, to serve as a medium of exchange and an investment store of value, if they linked this digital money, which I like. I like it as an alternative currency. I'm a Hayekian. I like alternative money.
They changed the name. Quit calling it the Bitcoin. Call it the Hayek.
All right. Call it the Hayek. That's exactly right. Make it legal tender. Link it to gold. And then you can trade it, and it'll have staying power on all these transactions. They actually could do this. This is the Winklevosses, by the way. the guys who went up against Mark Zuckerberg.
Well, that's a good housekeeping seal of approval.
Well,
on this
you know, those guys have had their ups and downs, but I think they may have something.
To me, Bitcoin smell, conceptually, it makes sense, and then I'd short it. I like to short gold because I don't know what the intrinsic value is. I don't know what the intrinsic value of bitcoins are. To me, it smells like Ponzi scheme and the greater fool theory right now.
It has no moneyness.
Intrinsic value. Most people don't understand
what it is. There has to be a moneyness of money in order to do this kind of thing, and they don't have it. That's why I suggested the gold play.
But Nick Colas of Convergex Group still sees value in bitcoins and calls it gold for nerds. Good to see you both. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us, Nick. So gold for nerds? What do you mean by that?
Yeah, what I basically mean is that gold is a finite supply, and people for many thousands of years have found gold valuable. And Bitcoin is somewhat the same way, although obviously newer. It has the additional benefit of eventually being a transaction mechanism to make global commerce a lot more efficient as well. So there's multiple ways to look at it.
Hold on a second. I've got to explain exactly what Bitcoin does. I give my real dollars to Bitcoin, and I establish a Bitcoin virtual currency account. That's how it works. I can then use my virtual Bitcoin currency to buy anything I want online, including guns, drugs, or anything else. You got the picture? Now we find that we've got a couple of items, a couple of incidents here, where people do actually buy things online using Bitcoin. I've got a father and son from Austin, Texas. They bought a 2007 Porsche for 300 Bitcoins. That's about $39,000. A Canadian man listed his two-bedroom bungalow for sale online. He's asking $400,000 or 5,750 Bitcoins. Charles, you like this. You think this is going to, it's like gold to you.
I'm intrigued by it. I haven't put anybody in it. I'm still trying to learn about it. It's obviously pretty interesting because besides buying things, the big story, one of the bigger stories is that Bitcoins will be the ultimate store of value. In other words, they're going to make a limited amount of them because they've already done the computer modules, whatever, and there's going to be a certain amount and that they will adjust. So ultimately, one Bitcoin, according to some, could be worth equivalent to $1 million.
Well, yeah, okay, that's a prophecy.
That's the hype behind it. Yeah
that's the hype behind it.
Boy, it feels great to be a Bitcoin millionaire. I'm loving it. Bitcoin has absolutely triumphed as the dollar has crashed 90%. Against Bitcoin, as Bitcoin is set to take on the world and root out the banksters, as we sorely need. That's the economy. You know, this is what their theory is. This is what the academics say. This is what the PhDs believe. This is what the neoliberal model suggests. But it's all a bunch of nonsense. Did I mention how good it feels to be a Bitcoin millionaire?
Yes. And how do you like this rain and snow and
this,
and construction?
The clouds are opening up to herald the arrival of Satoshi Cyberchrist. Christ is back, and he's got Bitcoin.